In this video, we will discuss a bit about one of the most complex areas of physics. This topic is, of course, cosmology. While this topic traditionally had nothing to do with relativity, I've chosen to add it here because modern cosmology has a lot to do with relativity. When we look into space, we see many objects, and in order to see objects, we must receive photons or light from these objects. Light was first understood with the help of special relativity and modern electrodynamics. As discussed previously, in modern cosmology, we also use general relativity as one of the main tools to understand and model the universe that we observe. But of course, cosmology is about much more than relativity. This field of study uses all aspects of physics, including Newtonian mechanics, thermodynamics, quantum mechanics, and quantum field theory. Thus, to tackle cosmology, we more or less use the whole toolbox of physics to at least attempt to understand the universe we live in. In this video, we will discuss some general aspects of cosmology, and then we can discuss details in separate videos. Cosmology is one of the oldest topics in physics. It became a rigorous science after the Copernican principle was introduced in the 17th century. This principle states that all celestial objects are governed by the same physics. This might seem obvious today, but back then it wasn't clear if physical laws would be different on Mars, as an example. With Newtonian mechanics, we got the first laws that allowed us to understand things like planetary orbits, and this we have already discussed in another video. But back then, we couldn't understand much outside our own solar system. The field of cosmology only began to really get moving with Einstein and his theory of general relativity in 1915. We finally got a theory that corrected the mistakes of Newtonian mechanics and which we could trust for describing the universe beyond our solar system. The theory of general relativity gave us many new things, such as black holes, gravitational lensing, where light bends around objects. After 1915, many interesting discoveries and observations were made in the following years, and with the Friedmann equations, we got a model of the universe as a whole. Not long after did Irwin Hubble discover galaxies outside of our galaxy, the Milky Way. All these developments of the 20th century form the core of modern cosmology, but we are still discovering new things and learning more about the universe. Our understanding of cosmology comes first and foremost from observations, so let us talk about some key observations in recent times. One of the most important discoveries of the previous century is without a doubt the discovery of the cosmic microwave background. We have discussed this topic before, but it deserves a video on its own. But it is essentially the oldest light in the universe from when the universe was very young. By observing the cosmic microwave background, or CMB, we can learn a lot about the universe, such as the matter and energy content of the universe. We have also been able to observe very distant supernovae, and by looking at the redshifts of such objects, we've gotten a much better understanding of the expansion of the universe. The fact that the universe was expanding was first understood in the 1920s, but only in recent times did we realize that the universe is expanding at an increasing rate. This led to a Nobel Prize in 2011. The things mentioned so far has all helped scientists to improve our understanding of the universe, and it led us to the Lambda CDM model, which we have already discussed, and this model is mathematically based on the Friedmann equations. There are, however, still some big mysteries left to resolve. One problem is the fact that in the 1930s it was discovered that galaxies move too fast in galaxy clusters. Thus, a quick commutation would indicate that the gravitational pull in these clusters is not strong enough to keep the galaxies in orbit. This originally led to the proposal of dark matter, a new type of matter that only interacts gravitationally and is therefore next to impossible to detect. In more recent times, the evidence for dark matter has piled up, and this has led to the fact that dark matter is essential in our understanding of the universe. To make sure this assumption is correct, physicists have tried very hard to figure out what new particle could be behind this dark matter, but so far with no success. Another mystery is the gravitational constant or dark energy. This is the energy which acts as some kind of anti-gravity and that is causing the accelerated expansion of the universe. What this dark energy is still a big mystery. Another interesting field of study in cosmology is the new field of gravitational wave studies. Gravitational waves are waves in the fabric of space-time itself, and we only managed to observe the first gravitational waves in 2016. The theory behind these waves comes from general relativity, and likewise gravitational waves have been predicted by theory for decades, and in this sense they are nothing new. But the problem is that these space-time ripples are so small that we need extremely precise tools, using all the tricks of modern physics, to be able to detect these waves. Gravitational waves form when very heavy objects in space merge. An example of this is when two black holes merge into one big black hole. It was a gravitational wave from such an event that was detected for the first time in 2016. As our technology gets better, we can detect even smaller wave signals, and this will open up new ways to discover new physics and test current theory. It is expected that there will be a gravitational wave background, just like the CMB, and this could tell us new things about the early universe because these signals can come from an even earlier time than the CMB signals. Another interesting aspect of cosmology is structure formation. That is how galaxies, stars, and solar systems are formed. This is an extremely complicated topic, but one can get quite far by considering just Newtonian mechanics. The universe is, however, extremely big and complicated, and therefore we don't have particularly accurate models for how large-scale structures form. There are many unknowns, but one of the ways to learn more is simply to look out in space and see what is there and make a map of the universe. Then one can also look at places where objects like stars are still forming, and in this way get a good idea of star formation. Likewise, one can look at young galaxies, and by capturing these snapshots from different galaxies and stars forming, one can try to assemble the puzzle. This will, however, still take many years, so for now, structure formation, especially at large scales, is not well understood, and dark matter likely plays a role in this puzzle. Cosmology has come a very long way the last century, and we have realized that we live in a really huge universe. Interestingly enough, we still don't know if the universe is infinite or not. This is simply due to the fact that we cannot see any edge of the universe. This is because the universe is so large that there are galaxies so far away that no light signal have reached us, so we simply cannot see objects that far away. Likewise, we still have much to learn about the early universe as we eventually reach a point where we go beyond known physics. So while there's still a lot of stuff we don't know, progress has been made, and with the help of new experiments and new physics, we can expect to learn and understand more in cosmology. Related to cosmology is of course the issue that general relativity cannot be the final theory for gravity, as it doesn't handle small scales correctly, and related to that, we would most likely need some unified theory for all forces to resolve some of the fundamental questions in cosmology. So we will have to see what the future brings. In summary, the equation of motion for the time evolution of the universe is described by the Friedman equations, or more precisely the FLRW matrix, which we obtain from solving the Einstein's field equation for a universe like ours. To figure out the parameters of this model, and thus to figure out how our universe looks, we have performed countless of experiments and observed the universe to figure out how our universe looks and behaves. Particle physics play an important part in understanding many microscale phenomena, like how the sun works and how many other objects in space behave. We essentially need almost all fields of physics to understand every aspect of our universe, and this is one of the reasons cosmology is so complicated. We have, however, learned much in the past century, and if we keep up the pace, then we will learn a lot more in the coming decades. As always, I hope you liked the video and learned something new. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section and feel free to like and share with your friends. If you would like to support the work of this channel, please check the link in the description. Stay tuned for the next video.